career. I just made the decision that I wanted to spend the time with them.
Was that a positive coming out of sports and having that time again with
family? Well, it was difficult because the transition for me was very difficult. Mm-hmm. I'd been, from the time I remember, athletics every day.
Athletic thoroughbred.
And I loved it. Either as a player or as some of the coaches know, mm-hmm. I mean, you always feel you got your hands on it. And that was difficult, but eventually, I mean, the transition was very difficult for mm-hmm. me, no question about it. And then...
What made it difficult? What was the difficult part? Just leaving the sport that you love, that you've done your whole life?
Well, I was either playing or working out pretty much year-round, 12 mm-hmm. months, because as soon as the season was done, you take a little time and then get ready for the next season. Now, the emphasis on staying in shape and strength training, core training, isn't what it is now. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, I had to fight for a job. I never had a multi-year contract when I played, so that was fine, because I knew I had to be at my top level and compete every year. Mm-hmm. But just getting into the so-called real world, you know, at that point, then I was hoping I could still get hooked up with a team. But
so
then
you kept thinking about, I'm still playing, I'm still a player, you had that identity. It took you a while to kind of relax from that. I mean, I don't know how many years, you have an idea how many years it took you to finally realize I'm no longer an athlete?
Right. And then at one point, when the phone wasn't ringing and my wife would say, okay, what are you going to do now? And I'd say, oh, blank, honey. I don't know.
Yeah.
Not sure yet.
Yeah, I'm still waiting for that phone call.
I'm waiting for the
somewhere.
Phone call, you know, because that obviously for people, you're not going to make that kind of money
right. And
do the things that you're doing when
so
you're playing.
So, I mean, you have a financial change. You have the emotional change of being caught up with the team and the camaraderie and the competitiveness. And so you had that transition out, and it was, like you said, it was difficult coming out and making decisions. And you did some different jobs on and off. I mean, at some point you started working jobs and doing different things. And I guess briefly to talk, what were some of the highlights of coming out of pro sports and being an ex-pro athlete and working some different jobs? Or what kind of things helped you with that coming out of pro sports?
Well, it was difficult, and I think for most athletes, except for the ones... When I was playing two sports, mm-hmm. I did what I had to in school to stay eligible because I was so much time on the field, films, practice, games,
you were working, you worked hard.
And playing two sports, very few people do that. So to go into that transition, you're used to the notoriety,
the
things that you feel, the attention,
and
now all that's gone. I mean, there's
that.
Still a little bit, but you go from here to here in a hurry.
Well, and you have something now that I think you're very passionate about. I mean, something that, in my opinion, in the years that I've known you, that I haven't seen you this passionate about what you're doing now. And you want to tell us a little bit about that, about what you're doing now?
Well, I work with a company that's located in Detroit. It's called Detroit Pencil Company. It's an office supply and office furniture, and there's some U of M people that I've known for a lot of years. Mm-hmm. In fact, I was looking for a job. All of us know what's going on with the economy and things here in Michigan, and it's extremely difficult. So number one, I was happy to have a job. Number two, I was extremely happy to something that I had some passion mm-hmm. and look forward to on a daily basis.
And you're doing sales now and
doing
out and
sales,
about, meeting
all
people,
around.
Shaking hands, doing
absolutely.
A lot of things. We're going to come back in a moment. We're going to take another break here, and when we come back, we're going to have questions from our live studio audience from Glory Days.
Tell if you've had way too many. But what if you've had just one too many? Buzz driving is drunk driving.
Hello, I'm Sir David, and for this segment of our show, we're going to take some live studio audience questions. Let's go to our first question, Rick.
Rick, what's your favorite Bo Schembechler story?
My favorite Bo Schembechler story. I'll try and keep the language clean, but my first scrimmage that I was ever in at Michigan, I tried to throw a little crossing pattern over the middle, and it got intercepted. And he was running at me, and I can't use all the language, but the question he was asking me says, can you throw a football through a picket fence? Well, I thought he was talking about my arm strength and not my accuracy. So I said, well, yeah, coach, I think I can. And his eyes got about that big and he threw his hat and he says, "You're too effing stupid to even answer the question right." That's how I started out as a freshman.
One of your favorite moments, was it? Or one of the many moments?
That made a quick impression on me.
Yeah,
I said college ball is a little different than what I'm used to.
We know that you have a lot of great admiration for Coach Sembeckler, and that he was like a father figure almost of those years at Michigan. Great man, great impact on your life and everything. Great first impression. What was your last impression with Coach?
Well, when I was informed of his passing, it was extremely difficult for me. I was in northern Michigan deer hunting, and it was right before the Michigan-Ohio State football game. So just a lot of memories. I had always said he was the greatest coach and the greatest competitor that I had ever been around.
Yeah, great memory.
Yeah,
let's take our next question from our studio audience.
Yeah, Rick, Mr. David was asking you about changing from your professional life going into the real world. You know, maybe you'd like to speak a little bit about how much easier it was having three boys that were involved in athletics and what a thrill that probably had to be for you being able to watch your sons.
Well, I'm glad you asked that question, because the highlight for me, number one, I've got three boys that are 3 years apart. They all attended North Farmington High School and had wonderful careers there. But for me, all three of them, one has graduated from the University of Michigan, and right now I have a senior and a freshman at the university. And to be honest, all the things that I'm proud of and that I accomplish, it means nothing. Not nearly as much to have my boys go through there, to be at the university, and to have the four-year experience that they've had there. And I'm just so proud as a father that they could be there and go through and see a lot of the things that their mom and dad went through.
And that Leach name is well-known and will always be known at University of Michigan in Ann Arbor for those years, from the impact that you had there, from your father, from the other people that came before you, and the Leaches that are there now and will be after you. So, well, I'm Kurt David, and this wraps up another episode of our show. I'd like to thank our guest, Rick Leach, for joining us today.
Thank you.
Please join us next time when we watch the stories of professional athletes unfold from Glory Days.
Underwriting provided by
Metasports Management, a leading full-service sports representation firm servicing some of the finest athletes in professional sports. Metas also provides marketing and endorsement opportunities for current and past professional athletes. Your on and off the field source of wisdom and knowledge, Metasports Management. Space Care Interiors, a complete turnkey operation for an efficient office. Contract furnishings, design, construction, move management, and more. Located at 2222 West 11 Mile Road, Berkeley, Michigan, or online at spacecareinteriors.com. Smith Advertising International is a cutting-edge agency specializing in social media marketing outlets, production and distribution of website-ready videos, language translation, and much more.
DC Sports is an exclusive sports memorabilia company providing quality service for silent auctions, retail sales, and celebrity appearances. A leader in Metro Detroit since 1987, DC Sports is located at Lakeside and 12 Oaks Mall. Visit us online at DetroitCitySports.com.